In the last lesson, we learned how to set up Vitest in our project, and then we wrote a simple test to check the square root of a number. In this lesson, we're going to build out our notification component and test that it works as intended. To focus on testing, I've already built out our component. You can copy the code for the component below or from the GitHub repository in the lesson resources. Let's create a new file in our components folder called notification-toast.vue and add the following code to it. This is a simple component that can display notifications to the user. It accepts two props: status, which specifies the type of notification, error, success, or info, and message, which is the text to display in the notification. Our component also emits an event to clear the notification whenever the close button is clicked. Let's display this component in our app and confirm that it works. Inside of our app.vue file, we'll import ref from Vue, as well as our notification toast component. We can then set a default value for our message prop. We'll create a clear notification function that sets our message value to an empty string. And finally, we can now display our notification toast component in our app. Let's head over to our terminal to run our app using the yandev command. If we visit our app in the browser, we can see our notification toast component being displayed. There may be instances where you need to test a component independently without all of its features. VueTest Utils provides a set of utility functions and methods to mount and interact with Vue components in an isolated manner. This dummy component is called a stub, and to use its stub in our test, we will need access to the mount method from VueTest Utils, the official testing utility library for Vue.js. Let's install VueTest Utils into our app. We'll run yarn add dev VueTest Utils. Alternatively, we could use npm. We'll also need to be able to emulate a browser environment while testing. This will give us some access to some browser APIs and will allow us to be able to test our components without interference from the actual environment. In our case, an actual browser. Vitest currently supports two packages that can help us achieve this: HappyDOM and JSDOM. If you open your package.json, you'd see that we've had JSDOM installed for us automatically during setup. JSDOM has also been configured as our environment in our vitest.config.js file. Now that we've built out our component and installed the necessary dependencies, we need to decide what features of our component we'll be testing to ensure that it works as intended. Our tests need to check for the following. First, that the component renders the correct style depending on the notification status. Second, that the notification slides up when the message is empty. And finally, that the component emits an event when the close button is clicked. With these goals in mind, we can start writing out the tests for this component. Let's create a file called notification-toast.test.js inside our test folder and set it up for testing. First, let's import the mount method from vue.test.utils, our notification component, and the three main vtest methods that we discussed in the last lesson. Let's initialize our test suite with the describe method. In our test file, let's create a new test block for the first test. Our first test checks that the style of the notification rendered matches the notification status. That means if we get an error notification, we expect the background color to be red. Success will be green and info would be blue. We want to create a variable called status, which is a reference to the status prop we use in our component. We can then assign the value of error to it, which is the notification type we're currently testing for. The next thing we want to do is create a variable called wrapper, and we'll use mount to stub our component for the purpose of testing. Mount accepts two arguments. The first is the component we wish to replicate the functionality of, and the second is a list of options. These options provide different properties that ensure our components work as they would in the browser. In our case, we only need the props property because our notification toast.vue component needs at least one prop to function correctly. After adding this option, we pass in the prop that we need. In this case, we only have a status prop. We can finally write an assertion to conclude our first test. It's going to check that the notification component renders the correct style for an error type notification. We'll use the expect method, which accepts our stop component with all the options. In our case, we've named this stub component wrapper for easy reference. We're going to check that the component's class list returns an error that includes the notification error class. We can achieve this by using the classes function, which returns an array containing all the classes for that component. Now we can assert that the notification error class exists in this array by calling our toEqual function, which basically checks that the value x is equal to y. Let's run this test to confirm that it's passing. Let's go into our terminal and run the yarn test command. Now that that is passing, we can repeat the same process for the other notification types, success and info. Now we'll rerun our test to confirm that they all pass. Now that we're done with our first test, let's get started with writing our second test. According to our code, when users click the component's close button, we emit our clear notification event that resets our message prop to an empty string. We're also adding or removing a notification slide class depending on the value of this message prop as seen in our code. Let's write a test that checks if our message is empty before it slides up. Set up a new test block and create a message variable with an empty string inside of it. Next, we're going to create a variable called wrapper, mount our dummy notification toast component, and pass this message variable into it as props. We want to check that when the message prop is empty, our notification slides out of the app. So, let's write an assertion for that. We'll check the classes array of our component and ensure that it does not include the notification slide class, which is responsible for keeping our component in view. Now we can rerun our test to confirm that they are all passing. In our final test, we want to make sure that the component emits an event whenever the close button is clicked. This is an important feature to test because we want to make sure that, apart from UI features, the functionality of our component works as intended. For this test, we're going to use an async function because we're going to be triggering an event which returns a promise, and we need to wait for this promise to resolve in order to catch the changes that this event would cause. Let's initialize this test with an async function as its second argument. In a similar fashion to our previous tests, let's create a wrapper variable and assign it to our dummy notification toast component. Our options argument is a data method, and it returns a clicked property, which would be toggled between true and false every time it is clicked. To trigger this click event, let's attach our button to a variable. Create a new variable called closeButton and use the find function to fetch the button. The find function is similar to the native query selector function in JavaScript, as it accepts either a class, an ID, or an attribute, and returns an element. After finding our button, we need to trigger the click event. We can do this using the trigger function. The trigger function accepts an event, executes it, and returns a promise. For this reason, we await this action in order to ensure the changes to our DOM have been made before we make an assertion based on this event. So we want to make sure we use the await keyword before triggering the click event. Finally, we can check the list of events that our component has emitted using the emitted method, which returns an array of events. Like our previous examples, we will need to check that this array includes the clear notification event. Let's confirm that all our tests are passing. We'll also need to test that our component renders the correct message to the viewer. Let's head over to our code and set up a new test block. Create a message variable with a simple message. Next, let's mount our dummy component and pass that message as a prop. Our assertion is going to check if the right message is being displayed on the app. We want to find our message text using the p tag that displays our message, and then check that its text is the same as our message prop. Please note that in most cases, you'd want to replace the p tag here with a class name or an element attribute, but this will suffice for our solution right now since there's only one paragraph tag in the component. We can extract the content of the element using the text method, which is similar to the native inner text function in JavaScript. Let's assert that this value would be the same as the message using our toBe function. Let's run our test one more time to ensure that everything works correctly. In this lesson, we learn how to write unit tests for our Vue components using Vitest and Vue utils. We focus on testing our notification components to ensure that its UI and functionality behaved as expected. We also learn how to create dummy components that act as temporary replacements for our actual components so that we can focus on testing that component without worrying about some of its external dependencies. In the next lesson, we're going to be working on snapshot testing. See you there.